for 2014 Snowfest Girl Candidates. Kendra Klima, escorted by Joseph Holland. Bailey Crumwoody, escorted by Andrew Warnke. Lexi Lukuma, escorted by Court Allen. Madison Merges, escorted by Darren Jones. Abigail Miller, escorted by Ryan Gailey. Megan Steven, escorted by Jacob Zander. Please introduce our 2014 Snowfest Guide candidates. Riley Grunhagen, escorted by Gabrielle Grunhagen. Alex Smith, escorted by Shania Carl. Jacob Tintis, escorted by Jamie Weir. Dylan Youngren, escorted by Mackenzie Uter. Garrett Zander, escorted by Kayla Mock. Now we will do our fashion show, showing off the days of the week. Monday, PJ Day. Tuesday, Disney Character Day. Last color day. Freshman, orange. So I got a little joke quick. So, what did the alligator wear to school? Or what did he get called at school? He got called an investigator. Sophomores, pink. The girls, the candidates, will be holding. The boys will lie on the ground and have to eat it all without using hands. And the girls will be blindfolded, holding the stick over them with the donut tied to it. So we need all the boy candidates and girl candidates to stand up.
Thank you. Jacob and Alex. Dylan. And then Sam
about the candidates.
And we'll start off with Joe for Kendra.
Let's go Kendra, not me. All right, so I had the privilege of escorting Kendra tonight. Right there. And I just want to say a couple things about her. First of all, that she's probably one of the nicest girls in our school. And it's pretty cool that she's up here tonight, and not gonna lie, I voted for her. But she's just super nice and enthusiastic, and if you've seen her, obviously right now she's even smiling. She's always smiling and laughing, and she's very enthusiastic. If you haven't seen our cheerleaders this year, she goes ham. I mean, she's doing the Harlem Shake, and she's always starting that thing up. She has no shame. But out of all seriousness, one of the reasons why she's not only my friend but an inspiration is I've known her throughout my middle school days and my high school days, and I've seen her get picked on, and I've seen her, like, people put her down and stuff, but this year, it's just been really great for her. She's friends with everyone, and she's really transformed into a great person. She has not changed for anyone. She's always been her own person. She'll dress her own way. She doesn't care what you think. And I think it's great for her to be up here. And I think everyone up here is a fantastic person, but I think she deserves to be home, or not homecoming, Snowfest queen. So, Kendra.
Joe, thanks. I got this. Bailey and I, like, aren't the best of friends. We don't, like, hang out all the time. Just wait, I'm not even close to done. We don't hang out much, but there are a few things I do know. I know that Bailey is a positive spirit who can always lighten up a room. And she's always smiling. I mean, look at her. Right now, just like Kendra, like Joe said, I think, personally, she deserves to leave tonight with a crown because Bailey's an awesome person. In my time knowing Bailey, a few things rise above the others. Her optimism, her great attitude towards life. I think those are the same thing, but I still think so, that's right. And I think I've said awesome like 5 times, but she's just plain awesome. She's an awesome friend. Awesome. She raises the bar high for herself because she doesn't like to give herself a break. She likes to work hard, and work hard, she's done. Stupid. So I just want to say thank you, Bailey, for allowing me to escort you. Thank you very much.
Now, Cor will give a speech about Lexi.
All right, Lexi has always been my good friend. Ever since I met her, first day, I don't know if it was down the halls or something like that, she just lit up the room. She's just always a joy to be around. She's kind, she's caring and compassionate. She also loves to laugh in gymnastics, and I really got to know her well during the plays and stuff like that. We enjoyed laughing backstage, you know, having a good time and stuff. So also I'd like to wish Lexi a happy birthday because today's her birthday. So happy birthday.
Before you sing happy birthday, birthday to her? Since you were in the quartet, will you sing happy birthday to her?
Oh, sure. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to Lexi. Happy birthday to you.
Now Darren will give his speech about Maddie.
I've known Maddie for 4 years now, and I can say she is the most down-to-earth girl I know. She is sweet, caring, smart, pretty, and hilariously funny. Most of you probably know this beautiful girl, but if you don't, here are a few fun facts. Maddie is all about that croc life, so I never talk bad about him. She quotes movies like it's her job. She's obsessed with Kevin Love. She's deathly afraid of heights. She's possibly going to college in Hawaii. She's a member of the National Honor Society. She hates having her neck touched. She has a huge crush on the Franco brothers, especially Dave. She loves music. She probably knows like every song out there. Any song you want to play, she'll sing it. She hates all kinds of sauces, ketchup, barbecue, nothing. She likes it plain. Her favorite animal is a killer whale. And lastly, Maddie can rap.
About Abby.
When Abby asked me to be her escort to Snowfest, I told her absolutely. I knew I had to write a speech about her, and the first thing that came to my mind is that she went to prom with my best friend last year, so she's obviously a pretty cool person. She must have a great taste in guys, because first it was prom with Darren, and now I'm escorting her. In all seriousness though, there's so much more to her than that. First off, she's amazing at basketball, and it's fun to watch her and the entire girls basketball team during this season. Abby will even be continuing her basketball career in college, playing with St. Ben's. Not only is she very athletic, but she is also an outstanding leader in NHS and student council. I'm not the only one that will say that in every activity that she participates in, she's always kind and easy to talk to. This next subject was a bit hard for me to write about, since Abby and I have been competing since middle school. So I put in the best words that I could, and it's a motto that we both share. If it's not an A, it's not okay. That motto was actually made by Megan Stevens. She told me it'd be plagiarism if I used it and didn't mention her, so. Yeah. So if there's anyone in our class that deserves to be valedictorian, it's her. Finally, I know that Kayla and I have been talking about how much it sucks that we can't use the excuse that we are king or queen anymore to get out of doing things. However, I'm 100% positive that the beautiful girl that I'm escorting tonight deserves to be able to use that excuse and Kayla's homecoming crown.
Now Jacob will give his speech about Megan.
Jacob! Okay, so I had the honor of escorting Megan this evening. And Megan is a great candidate for this year's Snowfest. During the school year, she's been involved in a lot of activities such as softball, volleyball, and student council. Along with that, Megan has been helping with a tough task and contributing to the creation of the yearbook. She enjoys long walks on the beach with her boyfriend of 2 years, Brody. Even though Megan is somewhat of a klutz and a blonde, she's still an honor student with on the A honor roll. People sometimes think that Megan is a brat, I don't know. But it's just her facial expressions. Everyone loves her, she loves everyone. So Megan is one of the most sweetest and most kind girls in this school. If you have any troubles in your life and just want to talk to someone, Megan's the one you should go to. She's also a little bit of a neat freak, and by little I mean a lot. She's always picking stuff up at church and around school, so if you have a dirty locker, call Megan. Megan is dedicated to pursue her dream and attend college school in Eden Prairie. The past few years I've gotten to know Megan through church and become really good friends. Megan's 100% deserves this honor tonight. And I'm actually surprised Megan's here tonight because of all our mixed ensemble mornings, she always made the excuse of being behind a bus so she couldn't make it. So I'm surprised she's here. So.
Thank you.
Good evening, everyone. I had the pleasure to escort Riley tonight. Riley is not only one of my best friends, but my cousin, and also like another brother to me. You guys probably don't know, but when we were little, we totally hated each other and always argued when we went to school at St. James. Now things have totally changed, and I can't imagine my life without him. I can go to Riley about everything, and he's definitely my best friend. Riley is such a sweet, caring, and kind guy. He would help anyone at any time of the day, and he has always been there for me. He likes to hunt, fish, and play sports. And oh, did I mention that he likes to fish alone? Not sure why. This kid is also beyond gullible and would probably believe anything that I told him. He can't spell for the life of him and never uses the words them and those correctly. He likes to read books in his free time. He definitely has me beat on how many books he's read. And he also reads Nicholas Sparks books. They're known as their most well-known romance author, so kind of weird. I don't know. Here are a few words to describe Riley. R for reliable, I for interesting, L for likable, E for easygoing, and Y for young. I think Riley is definitely well-deserving of this crown tonight.
Now Erin will give her speech about Sam.
I have the honor to escort my cousin, Sam Kiddock. Though we are cousins, we act more like brother and sister because we argue a lot, but Sam does have some better qualities than my own brothers do. He is very humble, caring, kind, and smart. For my 16th birthday, he gave me a homework pass, which was good for his help at any time. And since there's no expiration date on it and we're going to the same college, I'll still probably be using it in college. Sam is also very artistic. He once had his drawing of Trevor Mbakwe published in Sports Illustrated magazine. And some of my best memories growing up with Sam were when he was at our house when we were younger, we'd call it the Sam Kiddock sit-down strike. He would, when it came time for him to leave my house, he would plop down on the floor, cross his arms, and scream, "I'm not going." He had to be dragged towards the door by his parents, which made his sit-down strike not very effective. And then number two, while camping with our whole Kiddock family, Sam went missing for a little bit. And everybody, our whole family, spread out to search the whole campground, and we were unable to find him, so his parents started to stop cars and campers that were leaving the campground and asked permission to look for him in their car. And little did we know it, he was hiding under the mattress in his own tent. He got in just a little bit of trouble for that one. And then Sam is an amazing and talented guy, and we would be honored to have him as our king.
Now Shania will give her speech about Alex. Okay, so I'm escorting Alex Smith. Alex is very energetic and outgoing. I had physics first hour, and I was in a group with him and two others. I'm pretty sure he got me to talk more in physics than I did the whole rest of the day. He's super athletic and very good at every sport that he puts his heart into. Smart and helpful are the next words to describe him. He was always the best person to ask for help when I needed it. On top of all that, he is funny and very friendly. When talking to him, a laugh is always a guarantee. So I think Alex is more than deserving of this crown tonight.
Now Jamie will give her speech about Jacob.
Okay, so I'm escorting Jake. To be honest, at first when he asked me to escort him, I didn't even know he was nominated. But and all he said was wow, but I'm really happy that he got nominated. I think he's a great candidate for it. I asked Jake what I should say about him, because to be honest, I don't really know. And he just told me to tell you that he's nice, so I'll add that. Things about Jake. He's a really great guy. He's funny sometimes, not always. Sometimes he's really fashionable, other times he looks like a hobo. He likes to gel his hair when it's long, or when it's short, but when it's long, he also looks like a hobo. Jake's super tall. When I stand next to him, I come up to like the middle of his back, I think. He's officially gonna go to Rochester next year and play football.
Yeah.
And yeah, he's a great guy, and I hope he wins.
Okay, Dylan, can you hear me? This loud enough? Okay. Well, I've known Dylan since probably kindergarten. We live a mile down the road from each other. He's one of my best friends, and I'm really gonna miss him next year when he goes to Ridgewater. I think he's living with Peter. I don't know. a couple facts about Dylan. He loves to fish, hunt, ice fish, farm, and really anything outdoors. He's a crazy awesome wrestler, and he's set to break the school record for total career wins. I think he's 6 away, and the record's 148 wins, which is a crazy good accomplishment. Every year, myself, Gabby, Dylan, and Kayla go down to the state fair, and Dylan is always the life of the party, no matter what we're doing, showing the cows or just messing around. We could tell stories for hours about Dylan and all of his tricks. And I think I can speak for every girl in our grade when I say I've had a crush on Dylan in my life. And I don't care who you are, like anybody, you cannot stay mad at Dylan. You can't do it. No matter what he does, he'll look up at you with those big brown eyes of his, and give you that little smirk and be like, Kenzie, come on. And totally forgive him. Within a matter of 2 seconds, he totally forgot what you were mad about. And I have the honor of escorting Dylan tonight, and I think he's deserving of a crown. Everyone should have voted for him today.
Now Kayla will give her speech about Garrett.
I would just like to first thank Garrett for asking me to be his escort. It's an honor to escort such a great guy like Garrett. And so to start, I guess me and Garrett have known each other since we were babies. My aunt and grandma have a picture of us together in diapers. It's a little embarrassing. Well, now let's fast forward to the state fair this summer. Dallas, Aaron, and Garrett came to visit me and Kenzie down at the state fair. And they'd keep coming back to the barn, and every time Garrett would have something new to eat. He's the only kid I know that can spend about $100 on state fair food and not throw up. And he was obsessed with the world's largest boar for various reasons. But on a more serious note, Garrett is an awesome classmate and a great friend. He's also one of the most athletic guys in our grade. He was a star player of the football team, and this basketball season, he's crucial to the success of the team, and he's also the captain. Everyone can always count on Garrett for a good laugh. He's hilarious. The random things he does and the comments he makes in school is what makes his personality so fantastic, especially when he participated in Thrift Shop Thursday all the time last year. Overall, Garrett is an awesome candidate for Snowfest King and deserves to be this and more than anyone up here. Good luck tonight, Garrett.
Okay, well, we're gonna play another game, and it's charades. So each candidate will be given an animal, and they will have to act it out. And they have to act it out without words or sounds or anything, and their escorts will have to guess the animal they're acting out. So Kendra and Joe, please step up center. Okay, go.
You're swimming?
It's an animal.
Oh, it's an animal. What is this? It's obviously a bird.
No.
And a vulture? Falcon. A chicken. Eating a balloon? Pterodactyl. Rooster. Woodpecker. He's eating an egg. Is that an egg?
Joe, do you give up?
Does anyone have a guess out there? I said eagle.
Not an eagle.
A duck.
Someone in the audience said it.
Nope.
A penguin. A kangaroo.
One last guess. One guess.
I said hawk. Whoa! No way! Didn't I say hawk?
It's a hawk.
Hawk.
Okay, Bailey, Andrew.
Down. How many words is it? There's not many, too. So it is round, though. Round.
Armadillo.
Armadillo, I like that. They have small tails. It's seahorse. What do you say, rabbit?
Bunny.
Bunny. What? It's big. It's 2 meters approximately. Is it bigger than a bread box? Okay, it's bigger. Okay. It has a tail and it's round. Is it?
You need a hint.
Oh. Tie. Green. Tie. Stripe. Zebra. Those aren't round. Who said zebra? Tiger. Those aren't round either.
Do you give up, Andrew?
Shapes are.
Andrew, do you give up?
4 more guesses. I got this. Okay. Tie. Rhymes with tie, right? White. Black. Skunk. Oh my gosh. Okay, that's one, I think. It's not a zebra. Raccoon. Yeah!
Like the team court. Go.
A bird. Some sort of bird. A bee, a bee. A fly. A bumblebee. A mosquito.
A butterfly.
A hornet. A butterfly.
A bull. Omaha. Two words?
No.
Two ears. Okay, so it's on four legs. Rabbit, bunny rabbit, spider, because I hate spiders. Octopus. Ostrich.
Cat.
It's a T, X. Ox. Oxen.
There you go. Megan and Jacob.
Platypus.
Hippo.
Riley and Gabby. Go for it.
well, now is the time of the night that we've all been waiting for, the crowning. So can we please have all the boys stand up front? Well, candidates, boys. How's that? So we can crown the king.
I'm bringing sexy back. The blood of the ball is gonna have it out. Get special.